Hello YouTube, this is R&M Productions here with a review and test fire of my new rubber band gun, the Night Fighter by Magnum 12. This was found on the top of the ammunition, the rubber band's bag. It's up there. So, they claim to be the world's finest line of rubber bands, pistols, and rifles. They say never point it at anyone. Yeah, right. They're designed for target use only, blah, blah, blah. Use only official Magnum 12 ammunition. So that's probably just garbage because rubber bands are all pretty much the same. Like, this is just a normal rubber band, even though it's a special Magnum 12 one. They're the same price, though, but if you can't find them, just use normal ones. It doesn't matter. Just find the one that has a good stretch but isn't going to snap. But one thing, you might think that a tiny little rubber band would be great if you can get it to reach, but from here to here. But the thing about that is that it would be really, really light, so it would not be accurate or have good range. It would just go really fast for like a couple feet. So I'll start from the back here. It's got a stock that's useless because it's not big enough to need a stock. Scope, which is actually really helpful. It's surprisingly good on like most toy gun scopes. I put that rubber band on to keep it from flapping down, because when I was loading it kept randomly just flapping down, but now that rubber band keeps it up. Handle is pretty comfortable. It's a good length for me. I don't know how it would be for everyone else. I either pull with my pointer finger or middle finger. Don't really know. The plastic trigger is pretty comfortable, has a good pull, and it's actually surprisingly like soft. It must be a softer plastic. Up here to the workings of it, holds rubber bands on this, and when you pull the trigger, it allows them to be launched off, and then the arm snaps back in and stops launching them. So when I want to load more on it though, like 8 of them, I just do that by turning it again like that and just stretching them back around under there. Sometimes I would pull the trigger and this thing would just want to spin so fast because it has so many rubber bands that it would just keep that arm forced out and it would just go rapid fire and shoot like all of them until there was only a couple left and it didn't have enough force to push it back. I forgot to tell you, I think you can read that. Well, right there on the back of the scope, it says www.rubberbandguns.com. That is the website where they are located. You should check that out. Do not remove the peep site, blah, blah, blah. I don't see why that could cause any danger whatsoever. Always wear eye protection. Use under adult supervision. Patent pending. That's most of it. The pretty good stretch here. This is where it holds the rubber bands on this little red plastic thing. It gets a really good stretch from here to here. So now I will load it up. The stretch is powerful enough to be just as powerful, if not more, than normal. So I'm just gonna... Here, it's hard to do this one-handed. I'll hold it between my legs. So you just hook that rubber band. See? Behind a gear. And stretch it all the way up and put it in between that. And you can do 4 of those before you have to start doing my special I like to keep it on the, I'm blocking the camera there. See this rubber band? This is the shooting one. I like to keep it on the outside of the shooting arm, see, around it. I don't know why, it just seems better, gooder. So I'm gonna get that out of there. You can stretch that, and you can do 4 normal ones without having to do my little modification that allows you to do more. See, that is, and then the last one, I always stretch from the front because otherwise it snaps off real quick, but like that, it doesn't. So that's the normal 4. I'll shoot 1 round of these normal 4. The last one, for some reason, doesn't seem to be shooting, but then if I just tip it up a little, That's kind of too far. But if I just tip it up a little like that, shoots just like the rest of them. I think it's because of my modification, probably. I'll try to figure that out more later, and if I figure out what's really going wrong and how I can fix it, I will show you. So now I'm going to show you real quick how I normally shoot it. So it's just fingers, and you can see what you would prefer to have. Let's see. Can you see this? Darn it. Maybe if I go like this. Maybe you can hear that sound. I just stretch it in between this finger and hold it like that. Stretch it all the way back to my thumb here, and when I want to shoot, I just drop the thumb. I will show you that again. So I simply stretch it across my first finger, like that. Like that. And hold it like a pistol. And then I hook the back of it onto my thumb. This is a lot more difficult than it should be, because it is hard to hold a camera. Yeah, whatever. Okay, so I just hook it onto my thumb and my front finger and stretch. And that's been pretty powerful, but I think this is probably more or equal. Now I'll show you the modified stretching. The modified loading, I mean. I'll put on 8, how about? I don't think I could probably get much more than that. That might start putting too much strain on the plastic. And snap a little plastic arm in there somewhere. So that's 3, 4. So that's the normal amount. So the next step, you just grab one of these here, pick anyone, and force it down so the next one comes out, and then that arm, since it has so much more force pulling it back, will snap into place, and then you can hook another rubber band on. That's 5. And then you just put your thumb on this, and here, let's have you watch as that arm, what it does there. So, push it down really hard. And the next one comes into place, and since that arm is so much stronger, it snaps in and holds it there. Normally, it would just not snap in and let them all suddenly go out rapid fire while you're attempting to load it. It gets harder to push as you go, so I'd recommend loading before battle. I think the battles would be the most fun if you each got a limited number of rubber bands, and if you run out or if you get shot, you lose. Okay, I'm going to put down the camera for a sec to do the rest of them. There's the rubber bands. I think that's my 7th. One more. Okay, 8 is probably all it's going to be able to hold. And that is good, because that is the number I thought it would. Okay, shooting fire. Yeah, so 8 is probably a couple too many. See, it rapid fired off like the first 4. And then that last one still isn't shooting for some reason. So I would probably stick with 6. 6 works good. I'll show you 6. Well, I probably don't have time to do that. So you can just load on 6 by, once you do the 4, force that down, get that next one in there, and then you're all set. You can go semi-auto. I can actually, if you pull the trigger really fast, it's almost like it's rapid fire. It's really, really, really powerful. So there you go, the Magnum 12 Night Fighter. These are pretty cool. I really like them. They're like Nerf guns, just different, maybe better. So there you go. Enjoy. If you have any questions, ask in the comments. Please rate, comment, and subscribe.